population of black males is 7 times that of white males for the same crimes. The rate of... More and more people are being locked up for longer and longer. Locking up the mentally ill for long terms is not making us safer. Locking up those suffering from addiction is not making us safer.
Why? How did this happen?
When Charlie Wiggins plays politics, predators walk free.
It's my privilege to sentence you to life in prison without parole.
First, it was the politicians who used fear.
Went on a killing spree.
Some cities let criminals out.
And as a gang prosecutor, I've put dozens of violent criminals behind.
Keeping our communities safe.
One was Willie Horton, who murdered a boy in a robbery, stabbing him 19 times.
There's a story about a fella named Willie Horton.
Willie Horton.
Convicted murderer.
Murderer.
Convicted murderer.
Killer.
Murderer.
They rape people.
Raped his wife.
And they maul people.
Crime is something we're all concerned about.
Senator D'Amato is a leader.
We'll declare war.
For tougher sentences.
In jail.
Just to keep families safe.
Than the media.
He is described as a black man.
Black man.
Black.
Black.
As a
black.
As a black.
Black. Black man.
Young black male.
He's an African American male.
You are really. You understand what I'm telling you? Set it up.
Yes, I got it.
Set it up.
I understand.
Get your car over here and put it in.
I've got it. I'm in here.
Blacks and Latinos are typically portrayed as perpetrators, while whites are typically depicted as victims.
Nixon White House in 1968 had two enemies, the anti-war left and black people.
Fear-mongering from politicians.
And that retribution must be swift and sure.
Combined with racial stereotyping from the media has led to disastrous results.
But first we have to bring them to heel.
Three strikes and you are out.
Bad policies that cost billions and don't make us safer. Multiple studies have shown that locking up more and more people for longer and longer does not make us any safer.